exclusive here on Fox 24, Old Black Eyes is back. The legendary shock rock pioneer Alice Cooper came to the North Charleston Performing Arts Center, and we had the honor of sitting with his longtime touring drummer, Glen Sobel.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Glen Sobel, drummer for the Alice Cooper Band. You are watching Fox 24 News Now.
Glen, I cannot tell you what a thrill it is to be on stage with you. This is amazing. Thank you so much for having us.
My pleasure. You are on stage. This is where all the chaos is going to be tonight.
And how long have you been drumming with Alice Cooper?
In April, it's going to be 9 years. It's flown by like that.
You tour for long stretches of time.
We do, yeah. We're away from home a lot. You have to love what you do in order to be able to deal with the rigors of the road. The playing part, all this is the fun part. You get paid for the other 22 hours of the day.
Yeah.
The travel. We all love it, or else we wouldn't be here.
But something that we were talking about earlier is that it always feels good to come back home again.
Sure.
So what is that experience like for you?
Well, I'm born and raised in LA, so in a way, I'm very lucky. I was born in the right city. I didn't have to migrate there from somewhere else like most of my musician friends have done. And I've got great parents. I'm blessed for that. So it still meant there was a lot of hard work to figure out this whole crazy thing known as the music business. There's nobody that tells you, do this, don't do that. It's a lot of trial and error. Mm-hmm. So even though I was born there and I was starting to go to all the clubs, the rock clubs, the jazz clubs early on, it was a lot of hanging out and listening and learning.
Did you always know that you wanted to be a rock star when you grew up?
It didn't start like that. I loved playing music. I started playing drums in middle school. And every guy in that beginning music class wanted to play drums, and they had us all pick numbers out of a hat because you couldn't have 27 drummers. So there were two numbers left, two guys left, me and someone else. I picked the right number, major crossroads decision. I wasn't thinking at that point, I want to be a rock star. I just said, drums are cool. The guy, the older kid across the street from me, had drums. He was cool. So I wanted to play drums. And then I got into all the different programs in high school, marching band, jazz band, concert band, the musicals. And it slowly turned into, yeah, rock bands are cool. I think I want to do that. And you never hopefully set out to say, I want to be famous. That's the wrong path to set yourself on. You really have to just love what you do.
Just the skill of it. What else would you say is the foundation that you took from those early years that has now carried you all through your career?
Work ethic.
Yeah.
We were in marching band and we had these great instructors for drumline, guys that were from college marching bands or from drum corps, which are like serious professional marching bands, and we would warm up for like 45 minutes a day. And that was a whole lot of repetition. It's muscle memory. Yeah. And you learn, it's like, oh yeah, if you want to get good at something, you have to do it over and over and over again until you're just sick of it. And then you have to do it some more. There is no magic pill you can take. So it instills that real strong sense of having to put in the time, the 10,000 hours, as they call it. You know?
That it does take a long time to get really proficient. Do you feel like you're still not perfect? Or do you feel like you've reached the pinnacle of your career?
I practice every day, one way or another. If I can't get on the drums in practice, I'm on the practice pad. It never ends. You're forever a student of the drums.
Yeah.
That's the right attitude to take with this.
And you've not only toured with Alice Cooper, you've worked with so many different musicians. Can you name some of the other musicians that you've rocked out with?
Well, one of the more interesting times was when we, Alice Cooper, were the special guest on Motley Crue's farewell tour in 2015, and Tommy Lee had a severe inflammation of tendonitis in his right wrist, so I ended up filling in for Tommy Lee and Motley Crue for a week, doing both sets every night, and this is where school comes in handy. When I was in marching band and concert band, I learned to read music, and so I was able to make the charts, or the cheat sheets as we call them, and I was able to learn the whole set in a very short time. I had like 7 hours notice. That was a pretty crazy week.
Wow.
At that time, and played and toured with Richie Sambora, from Bon Jovi, who was another person I grew up listening to. A lot of surreal moments, because it's great when someone you grew up listening to becomes someone that you end up playing with. There's a professional relationship, but in the back of your mind, you're thinking, wow, this is crazy, you know? We were on our tour break a couple weeks ago, and I played a gig with Robbie Krieger from The Doors, another band I grew up listening to. He does this benefit thing in LA every year. And so we played a couple of Doors songs with him, and the list goes on and on. There's many. And with the Alice Cooper camp of people, a lot of people end up joining us because they want to jam with Alice and us. So we've had everyone from Weird Al to, Steven Tyler a whole lot from Aerosmith. And now there's the Hollywood Vampires that I play in, which is a whole nother sort of super group, which is Alice Cooper singing. And it's Johnny Depp on guitar. Yes, he could play.
I was just going to ask you that.
Yeah, and Joe Perry from Aerosmith in that group, and we tour with that. Last year was a couple of months in Europe, and there's more to come. We just did Jimmy Kimmel and James Corden. So again, it's one surreal moment after another, but you have to be professional. You can't be that person geeking out about who you're playing with. You got to just be the drummer holding it all together.
Yeah, that is absolutely true. And I'm curious though, how do you keep your discipline? When people think of rock stars, they think of partying hard. I mean, you look like a rock star, but when I'm talking to you, you don't sound like the kind of guy who's going to be busting up hotel rooms anytime soon.
Well, haven't you seen those things floating around on social media that drummers are the smart ones? We're not back there beer bonging Jack Daniels. And, you know, drummers, aspiring drummers, forget about all that stuff. Dean Martin was not drinking, he always said that he was drinking what? It was like Jim Beam
or
Jack Daniels. Yeah, he was drinking juice. It was all an act. No, we're driving the bus. We're not the front man. That's not our job at all. Our job is support. If I get a drum solo, that's great. I have a moment to shine. But otherwise, I'm in a purely supportive role.
I would absolutely be honored and would love to see you play for us. Would you mind playing a little something for us on the drums?
I could get warmed up, sure.
Let's do that.